You whores before the bot raid.
You whores! Yeah, let me bring up that clip again. E-girl domestications. There we go. I feel so naked without my bar to thank people. Please, oin? Oin!
Pippa made them? Yeah, Pippa made them. The flavor characters came about because of Pippa wanting to create an AI VTuber company. So she created Flavor as the company. She created all of the original Flavor characters, and then her and Panko, was it? Made the toxic generation for Flavor. That's how Pippa got canceled. Yeah. Yeah, I wrote that tweet longer and made VTweeters seethe, dude. Feet cam. I don't have anything to stand on. I don't have anything to stand on with my little feetsies. I guess I can just go over here. What a beautiful way to talk about e-girl domestication. And I wanted to talk about it on stream on Tuesday, but I forgot because my memory is non-existent. And so thankfully, Zekjala reminded me to talk about it today. So there was a guy in Terra that I knew. I don't know if he made the domestication contract for Terra specifically, or if he had made it prior to Terra. I'm not sure, but the domestication contract that I have here is dated.
It shouldn't be without
May
a redeem,
2019.
Right? My moderator's the one that reminded
so it's
me
been,
about
oh,
it.
Hey, this one has more than one.
Hell yeah!
So somebody
Hell
must have
yeah.
redeemed it, right? Right? Deploy. So, the domestication agreement. So, did I see all the shit Fruit Gautner quote retweets?
No, I did not.
This agreement is dated May 24th, 2019, and is effective immediately. The involved parties include, and there's a blank space, here and after the domesticated e-girl, referred to as DE from here on out, and a blank space for his name, here and after the extra large boy, referred to as the ELB from here on out. The DE is of the opinion that the DE has the necessary qualifications, experience, and abilities to support and benefit the ELB. The extra large boy wishes to request services from the domesticated e-girl. And both parties agree to accept and enter duoship upon the terms and conditions set out in this agreement. By definition of duoing, the domesticated e-girl agrees to prioritize spending time with the extra-large boy over other activities within reason. And the extra-large boy agrees to request services from the domesticated e-girl over other healers wherever possible, and to prioritize spending time hanging out often. The parties also agree as follows, the pocketer responsibilities. The pocketer will be responsible for following while the agreement is in effect, pocketing for the extra-large boy during evening hours for PvE content, reasonable performance by circumstance of the run of basic healer duties, including maintenance of buff-debuff uptimes for the benefit of the extra-large boy, and replenishment of HP and MP levels for the extra-large boy.
Terra was fucking
no
wild,
AFKing
dude.
During runs while pocketing, no flaming the extra-large boy, sleeping... Pocketing is an MMO term. Pocketing basically means that you are their pocket healer. You heal no one else besides them unless in extreme duress. You prioritize them over everyone else because you are their pocket healer. It also is a term in MOBAs, and it's even worse in MOBAs because those actually rely on your entire team being competent. And if you have someone pocketing only one person on the team, the rest of your team is not getting the assistance they need. Is this my mod application? I'm actually thinking about revamping this and turning it into something for stream, because I think that would be really fun. In call at least 3 days of each week where possible, have one movie night each week, and no ERPing unless it's the extra large boy. Extra responsibilities by request. The domesticated e-girl may provide extra services by request of the extra large boy, including Callouts for mechanics via voice chat comms. Timing burn phase buffs for the sole benefit of the extra large boy via voice comms. Usage of extra consumables, any tier of bravery potion, any tier of noctaniums or root beers, to augment performance levels for the benefit of the extra large boy. Ignoring weaker party members and prioritizing the extra large boy if the rest of the party is underskilled. One video date a month. Affection and attention when alone together doesn't mean sexually unless agreed upon. The pocketee responsibilities. The pocketee will be responsible for the following while the agreement is in effect. DPSing. Holding aggro and providing debuffs if the extra large boy is playing a tank role. No AFKing during runs. No ERPing during runs. And no flaming of the domesticated e-girl. Dealing high levels of damage to ensure that individual boss kill times do not exceed 4 minutes and 30 seconds within reasonable possibility.
Why is it so specific?
This excludes incidents where the rest of the party is overly underskilled. Providing consumables for the use of the domesticated e-girl if the domesticated e-girl runs out of consumables
Tara
mid-run.
Tara did have DPS meters.
Sleep in call at least 3 days of each week where possible. Have one movie night each week. Run at least 2 dungeons daily, within reason. And spend time trying to improve with the domesticated e-girl for both parties. Compliment the domesticated e-girl on improvements and overall praise when they are performing or behaving well. 4. Vacation time. The domesticated e-girl is entitled to any amount of vacation per week, depending on the activity levels of real-life events. However, they must at least communicate daily with the extra-large boy. Termination. This agreement will continue in full effect until terminated by either party. The parties are signing this agreement on the date stated in the introductory clause. And then there's, you know, the little lines for the signature and the date? That's, This is the fucking
vaccine
domesticated e-girl
real.
Contract that I keep talking about.
This was actually before COVID. This is a pre-COVID e-girl domestication contract. That is an important clause. Did anyone actually agree to this? There are a couple of people who have signed it. This is real autism. This is what they don't want you to know. You're 666% thankful that you never played MMOs with your buddy and we always were tank and healer, so you dictated everything. Oh, you only ever played MMOs with your buddy. Holy shit, did we dodge a bullet? That's true. You've only been part of boring and semi-competent MMO guilds. Where do people find this kind of tism? This kind of tism happens when you start getting into top-end guilds, either for PvP or PvE. Top-end guilds are almost entirely populated by autists. Man or women, they're all autists. All of us were autists in top ranking guilds. She served the extra large boys. No, I did not. But I did receive the contract. I did receive the contract and I was like, you know, I think I'll pass on this actually. That's too much commitment for a video game.